So, first of all, I want to say happy Mother's Day to every mother.
首先我要跟每个母亲说母亲节快乐。
I think that if there is a happiness index to be checked, I think Mother's Day must be the happiest day of the year.
我想如果你要来回顾呢，母亲节是一年当中最快乐的日子。
This index for us to check because it's like a happy birthday to every mommy.
就是它好像是每个母亲的生日。Because
every kid would know that on this day, you would try to do your best to make your mom happy.
因为每个小孩呢，他会在这一天特别要讨母亲的欢心。Maybe
you make her breakfast.
可能你为她做早餐。You
write her a card.
你写一张卡片给她,
or simply give her a hug.
或者是只是一个拥抱。
And daddies, because they want to set a good example, they will also try to be nice.
那做父亲呢, 他也想要做个好榜样, 所以他也会在今天特别的乖。
So if the mommy is happy, then everyone is happy.
所以如果母亲开心呢, 那每全家都开心。
So husbands, if you want a happy home, then be nice to your wife.
所以做丈夫的们, 如果你们想要有一个快乐的家庭, 那你要对你的妻子很好。
And children, if you want to have a happy home, then make your mom happy.
小孩子们啊, 如果你要让你的, 你们家里快乐, 那你就要让母亲开心。
You know, to keep things simple, I think we should have a be kind to each other day, every day.
那如果我们要把事情简单化呢，我们应该有一个每一天都是要彼此 恩慈相待的一日子。Then
we'll be happy every day.
那我们就会天天都很开心。There's
a wife who complained to her husband.
有一个妻子呢，她向她的丈夫 抱怨。She
said, "How come you're nice to everyone but me?"
这个为什么你对每个人都很好，除了你对我之外？And
the husband said, "Well, it's because everybody else is nice to me except you."
那丈夫说，因为呢，因为别人都对我很好，除了你。See,
back to reality. We know that it's our fallen nature that will cause us to mess up on every be kind to each other day.
所以呢，因为我们人性的这个天然性呢，我们就是常常会忽略了我们要对人每天对人良善。
Sometimes we even mess up on Mother's Day.
有些时候我们连母亲节也都忽略了。Therefore,
in line with our sermon series on how to live a blessed life, today we want to look into God's Word to find guidance and help on how to achieve true blessedness.
所以因为我们教会在最近一直在讲蒙福的生活，所以我们今天呢要来 分享的题目是一个蒙福的妇女就怎么样可以有蒙福的家庭。
Brothers and sisters, blessings comes from God. He is the true source of all blessings.
所以弟兄姐妹们，我们知道祝福是从神来的，神是所有祝福的源头。
Last week, Pastor Chung has said that the blessings that every one of us should run after, should seek and desire is not the blessing that usual people run after, material things that we run after.
所以上个星期钟牧师有提到说，要过一个蒙福的生命，那些福气不是世界的人所追逐的那些福气。
Rather, we should seek for a right relationship with God.
而是我们应该寻求跟神有对的关系。
Because it's only when we our position with God is right, and it's when we are restored as the sons and daughters of God, then do we have any hope at being happy, at being obtaining blessedness.
所以首先呢，我们就是要跟神有对的关系，恢复关系。有了这个对的关系，我们才可以呢得着从神来的这个信祝福。
You know, God has the only way that He show us the way that He bestowed blessing is through one man, His Son, Jesus Christ.
那我们知道呢, 神他要祝福人类呢, 他就是透过一个人，那就是他的独生爱子耶稣基督。
Through his substitutionary death on the cross, everyone gets to be initiated in the grace of God so that we may begin a relationship with him.
那透过呢，耶稣基督太代替我们死，所以呢，我们可以得着所有一切这个从神来的应许跟祝福。
Therefore, may we begin on the journey of blessedness.
所以我们就可以开始进入那祝福的道路。
So there's a principle here.
所以有个原则
that God blesses the world through one blessed person.
神祝福世界呢，是透过一个蒙福的人。
Through a person who is totally committed to do the will of God, through this one, he may bless many.
所以透过这个蒙福的人，因为他是全然的顺服神的旨意，透过他，他可以祝福全人类。
All it takes is one person, whether he or she is fully submitted to the will of God.
所以只需要一个人，那这个人就是一个全然顺服神的人。
Therefore, when we wish to have a blessed home, know that it needs to start with just one person. It would be better if there's more, but if only one.
所以我们知道说真的我们要祝福人要让神使用只需要一个人。当然更多有更多是好的，但是只需要一个蒙福的人。
And the Bible points to the mother.
那这个家庭里面呢圣经只是说到一个蒙福的家庭就是要有一个母亲。
Let's look at Proverbs chapter 31, verse 10.
看箴言31章第10节。
Can we read it together?
我们一起来念。才德的妇人谁能得着呢？她的价值远胜过珍珠。
Today we will find out from the Bible what constitutes a blessed woman.
今天我们要从圣经来看是什么样的这些的组合成为一个才德的有福的妇人。
The book of Proverbs is a book of wisdom.
箴言是一本智慧的书。
In the final concluding chapter of this book, chapter 31, it changes from its usual format of disjointed proverb into that of a letter written by a mother to her son.
所以呢，箴言这本书呢，它是从一般就是呢，的这些的谏言，这些的智慧的话语，改变一个格式到三十一章，成为一个母亲在跟儿子说话，
写的信。Ancient Jewish scholars think that King Solomon, the author of Proverbs, was writing about his mother, writing, teaching him, addressing him.On the duties of kingship and marriage.
那这个远古的犹太人，他们认为这本书呢是所罗门的母亲写给他，在告诉他怎么样当一个王，要的王权，还有是如何来管理。
And 关于他的婚姻，如何有美满的婚姻？
如何有美满的婚姻
？Yes. Do you remember who Solomon's mother was?
可是吧。
Yes, 别示巴。OK,
你记得所罗门的妈妈是谁呢？就是别示巴。
Yes, Bathsheba, the one that David committed adultery with, and the one with whom for whom he committed murder.
那别示巴呢？这个女士呢，就是我们知道，因为大卫王因着她跟她行淫乱，而且呢，因着她。而犯了谋杀的罪。
You think, how can such a person be godly enough or wise enough to be teaching King Solomon?
那你想这样的一个女人她怎么能够有智慧来教导她的儿子呢？
If you were here last Mother's Day, then you will remember that I had preached on three mothers in the Bible.
那如果你记得去年的母亲节我有讲到有提到有三个母亲
，one of which was Bathsheba，
其中一个就是别示巴。
A lot of people had misrepresented her。
那很多人都误解了别示巴。
I had said that her name Bathsheba Okay. It actually has the meaning of the daughter of seven or daughter of the oath. Because in Hebrew, bat means daughter. And shava means the number seven. Or it could also mean oath or swear.
所以别是八这个爸他意思是女儿 Shaba 是七个所以呢他的名字也可以说是七个当中第七个女儿啊他可能他的父母有七个小孩吧但或者他的意思是誓言发誓誓言的女儿
The reason the number seven is related to oath is because seven by their culture is the number of perfection
所以为什么这个七会意思是跟这个誓言有关系呢？因为这个七呢，就是你说 last 是什么？是
because seven has a connotation of perfection，
就是完全的意思。Yeah.
Do you remember there's also a well called Beersheba？ Okay, that is the well of seven or the well of oath。
那你记得有一个泉水呢，有一个井叫做。别是八井那就是好像这个井就是一个第七的井或者是誓言的井。
Okay. So, do you know what Bathsheba, you know, she was out of all the wives of David that bore sons to him, she was the seventh.
那别是八呢他是大卫呢帮大卫生小孩的妻子里面第七个妻子。
She was also the only one that David has swore on an oath to that her son would become the future king.
那她也是唯一呢这个母亲呢是大卫向她发誓说要让她的儿子来成为以色列的王。
The fact that God had chosen her over all of the wives of David to be part of the bloodline of Christ should tell us that she is more than just a pretty face.
所以你可以从这一点哦，看见大卫他在他众多的妻子当中，他选中他的儿子，神选中他，神选中别示巴的儿子。那可见呢，这个别示巴他不是只是有漂亮美丽的外表，
来在主耶稣基督的血线之中，
血脉当中，
血脉，
神拣选他成为耶稣基督的血脉。
It might be therefore.That the mother in Proverbs 31 was Bathsheba.
所以很可能在箴言31章这个写信的就是别示巴。
But the fact that this chapter is in the Bible means that there is a lesson for us all here.
那事实上这本31章呢这个也是给我们众人的许多的功课。
Wisdom, or you can say God, was speaking through the voice of the mother.
所以你可以说呢，就是说智慧，也就是神透过这个母亲在说话
，teaching us how to achieve blessedness in our homes，
在教导我们怎么样在家庭里面得着祝福。
From Proverbs chapter 31 verses 1 to 9, let us see what a blessed mother looked like。
那我们从箴言31章第一节到第九节，我们可以看到。一个蒙福的母亲是什么样子的
It started out with this verse
从第一节开始
我们可以一起念
吗利木伊勒王的言语是他母亲教训他的箴言
Okay, it says The word of King Lemuel The oracle which his mother taught him What is the meaning of the word The name Lemuel
那这个 Lemuel 就是穆勒伊勒这个意思是什么呢
？Next slide. Okay, Lemuel means to him. L. Okay, to him. L. L means God. So the word Lemuel means belonging to God, or you can say dedicated to God, vow to God.
所以这个字呢 ，Lemuel 哦，就是属于神的，也可以说是把你的儿女献给神。
And what does oracle mean?
那这个圣 oracle 圣
言
真言是什么意思
？It means the uttering of God.
就是神的话。
In another words, from that verse 1, we see that the one dedicated to God by his mother is repeating her teaching as coming straight from God.
那这句呢，就是说，就是他母亲教导他的话呢，他把它重复，如同是神亲自教导他。
So a blessed woman is a woman who sees her child as belonging to God.
所以一个蒙福的母亲呢，她看她的儿女是属于神的。
Is it possible that just like Hannah, Bathsheba also dedicated her son Solomon to God?
那是不是也像哈拿一样呢？别示巴也把她自己的儿子献给神。
She had lost her first child.
因为她失去了她第一个孩子。
Therefore, she decided to set aside her child for the service of God, out of her love for God, and also out of her trust in God.
所以呢，因着他对神的爱跟对神的信任，所以他再一次把他这个儿子来献给上帝。
I have dedicated all my three children to God.
那我也把我自己三个儿女都献给上帝。
Not only because I love the Lord,
不单只是因为我爱神
but because I love them.
因为我爱他们。
Because there's no safer place for my children than in the hands of God.
因为在没有比把他们献给神，神给提供给他们的最安全的保障。
A blessed woman is also one who sees the nobility in her children, and who prepares them for nobility.
所以一个蒙福的母亲，她会看到她儿女里面的尊贵。
Brothers and sisters, the Bible tells us that the people of God.We're destined to be kings and priests, but not only us, but our children as well.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，圣经里面告诉我们，我们是君尊的祭司，神要我们将来与他同坐完，不单是我们，我们的儿女也是同样的如此尊贵。
Don't just want your children to be doctors and lawyers, accountants, artists, entrepreneurs.Teach them first to be the servant of the Lord.
不要只是期望你的儿女成为医生、成为律师、成为工程师，而是你要先教导你的儿女要敬畏神。
It is not their profession that ennobles your children, but the spirit with which they perform their profession.
所以呢，你的儿女尊贵不是因为他的职业尊贵，而是因为他们。在行作他们的各个行业当中的那个灵里面那个精神那个态度使他们尊贵。
If you see your child as the future president or the future great person, would you treat him differently today?
如果你看你的儿女，你把他当作是未来的总统，或者是一个未来的一个重要的人物，那你想你今天对待他的态度是不是会不一样？
The mother of King Lemuel knew that he's going to be king.
那利木伊勒王他的母亲知道他将来是要成为王的。
Therefore, she is very careful about how to bring him up.
所以他就很小心的来怎么样来教养他。
Because her child is to be a king.
因为他知道他这个儿子将来是要做当国王的。
We need to look at our children that way because God wants our children to be kings and priests.
所以我们应当像他这样，我们把我们的儿女也看成如同将来他们要当王一样的来教养他们。
A blessed woman would instruct her children in the way they should go.
所以一个有智慧一个蒙福的妇女她应该按着神的方式来教导她的儿女。
Proverb 31:3-4
箴言31:3-4
Let's read it together.
我们一起来念。
不要将你的精力给妇女也不要有败坏君王的行为。
利木以勒啊
君王喝酒君王喝酒不相宜。王子说浓酒在哪里也不相宜。 And also the next one. In verse 4, 你当为为哑巴开口，为一切孤独的伸冤。你当开口按公义判断，为困苦和穷乏的辩屈。
八到九节。
Yeah, verse 8 to 9. So, we need to teach our children to do what is right.
所以我们必须教导我们的儿女什么是对，什么是错的。
Just like Tim Tebow's mother.
就像那个打足球的 Tim Tebow, 他的母亲。
Who knows Tim Tebow?
谁知道那个
叫做 Raise your hand if you know Tim Tebow.
Tim Tebow, 这个美国的足球。
Oh, okay.Okay, we need a little education here. Okay,
没有很多人知道他。
Yeah, Tim Tebow is a Heisman Trophy winner.
Tim Tebow, 他是一个就是
football player.
对，他是足球队的一个冠军得主。
Yeah, let me tell you something about his mother first.
那我先分享一下他的母亲的故事。
His mother Pamela Tebow and her husband.They were serving as missionaries in Philippines when, with their four children when she got pregnant with Tim Tebow.
所以呢 ,Tim Tebow 他的母亲叫 Pamela Tebow, 那跟他的父亲他们有四个小孩，当时他们是在菲律宾当宣教士。
And she contracted amoebic dysentery and had used very strong medicine to fight off the disease.
那时候呢他母亲呢怀孕怀了他，但是呢却得着了一种疾病啊，那他要用非常强烈很强的药物来抗抵抗那个疾病。
She didn't know she was pregnant then.
因为那时候他也不知道他已经怀孕了。
And the medicine caused a severance of her placenta from her womb.
所以这个药物呢让他这个里面这个胚胎呢造成了一些严重的反应。
Therefore, her doctor advised her to abort her child because the child is going to die within her and that will cause her death as well.
所以医生就劝告她说，可能你要把这个孩子呢，把它流产把它打掉，因为这个孩子可能在胚胎里面呢，他活不了。
所以他的生命危险，
他生命
母亲的生命危险，
母亲也会引起生命危险。
Yeah.But then she refused to do so.
但她母亲却拒绝了。
Her faith.
因为她的信仰。
They named her son Timothy long before he was born because they wanted him to be a preacher of God.
所以他们给他命名叫提摩太，就是在他出生以前他们就命名他提摩太，而且因为他们希望将来这个孩子能够成为一个传道士，能够
They would not allow fear or man's report to destroy their dream and vision for this child.
所以他们不允许从人来的这个惧怕，还有人的这个报告来摧毁他们的对这个孩子的意向跟梦想。
Even though Tim was born very malnourished, but he went on to become a strong, healthy young man and a man of God.
那虽然他刚出生的时候呢是非常的弱小脆弱，但是他后来却变得非常的健康并且强壮，而且是一个敬畏神的人。
He won the highest honor in college football when he was only a sophomore in college.
那当他在大二的时候呢，他就赢得了大学足球联盟的最高的荣誉。
And right now he is playing professionally and he uses every opportunity to tell people about God, to preach the gospel.
那现在呢他是职业的这个球员，那他都使用他任何在打球或是有平台的时候，他都在跟人分享关于神的事。
He and his mother became the spokesperson for the pro-life movement.And this is a short commercial that they did. This is a couple years ago. I think 2010, I think, or 2014.
那他跟他的母亲，他们同时也是成为一个就是
维持生命的代言人。
2010年。这是他的母亲。
Timmy, we're trying to tell our story here.
It's
Sorry about that, Mom.
This is Tim Tebow. 跟他的妈妈。
这就是 ，Yeah, this is Tim Tebow.
Well, yeah, you're not nearly as tough as I am.
那个this short commercial, she said, "Oh, I'm so worried about him, you know, when he was little, but then look at how big and strong he became."
那这广告就说，在 Tim 小的时候，我真的好担心他这么弱小，但是你看看他现在长得这么的强壮，这么的大。
And the next video shows you a little girl that commercial saved.
那下一个影片我们要介绍一个小女孩，就是因着这个他们那个影片呢、啊、而得拯救。
This is just one in many examples.
And that wasn't something that I planned at all.
她说她没有计划。
As nervous as I was telling him, because I knew how he felt, I really still just thought he would in the end be okay with it. Like, I thought that he was going to be like, oh my gosh, that's not what, you know, was the plan and what have you, but I thought that he would.
她想要跟她男朋友讲说她要留住她的孩子，可是她男朋友拒绝，她说你要堕胎。
I had never seen that out of him at all, so I didn't know what to say but to agree with him and say sure, okay.
So
I felt like I can't tell anybody about this, I can't talk with anybody about it.I need to figure this out on my own, was kind of how I felt, because I didn't want anyone to know that I was even thinking of that.
她不愿意堕胎，可是她的男朋友不允许她，就后来她去了这个看球赛，足赛。
That was all I could think about, it was consuming.
她说她一直在思想这件事。
There was no, I didn't know how to even make the decision, I guess. I didn't know what was I considering, what...I didn't even know how to think about it.
他就非常的现在迷失之中，不知道怎么办。
That was the night that I saw.
结果他就看到这个广告。
And so that's really what brought me to focus on the family.
所以他就有机会来联络那个机构。Oh, it was cut off. 没有看到他的孩子。Yeah. But because of that commercial, this mother decided to keep her child because she received help from that organization to help her to keep her child.
因着她看到那个广告，所以这个女士呢，她就决定留下她胎中的腹中的胎儿，所以她就。那个机构也帮助他。
The part that you miss is seeing how this little girl, baby girl, grew up to be a lovely, lovely girl.
所以刚刚我们少看到的那一部分就是，那生出来一个小女孩，那这小女孩长成一个很可爱的女孩子。
She became a single mother, taking care of her baby, but then she was so happy and satisfied.
那刚刚那位女士她就成为一个单亲的妈妈，但是呢她独自照顾她的女儿，但是她非常的喜乐。
A mother has a powerful role to play in the life of her children.
一个母亲她对她的孩子的一生是扮演的一个非常重要的角色。
Look at Solomon. He had 700 wives and 300 concubines. But how many mothers did he have?
你看看所罗门，他有700个妻子，300个妾，然后他只有一个母亲
，only one mother. Therefore, a wife should never try to compete with her mother-in-law for her son's affection. You will never win.
所以一个妻子呢，你永远不要跟你的婆婆来较真啊，因为你永远不会赢的。
She had done her part to nurture and shape your husband in his early years. You must give her credit and acknowledgement for all her labor.
因为母亲呢，她在养她的儿子，她在她年幼的时候，她在怎么样雕塑她、教养她，所以我们要必须认识到她所付出的所有这些的劳苦。
And maybe the character, the trait in your husband that attracted you to him was precisely the one that his mother had inspired.
也许呢，就是说你的配偶，你的丈夫，他吸引你的那个特性，哦，或者是他你喜欢他的那一个部分呢，正是他的母亲，教导他的。
On the other hand, a mother should never compete for the affection, of his one son's wife, in affection with your son's wife.
另外一方面呢，一个做婆婆的，你永远不要跟你的媳妇哦来竞争啊，因为这个
you will not win either.
你也不会赢的
，because she is the one who will keep your son company long after you're gone.
因为媳妇呢是在你过世以后，她要陪伴你儿子一段很长日子的一个人。
She will be responsible for feeding him, helping him, taking care of him, keeping him warm.
因为媳妇呢，她是要负责来供来喂你的儿子，来帮助你的儿子，而且来使他能够有舒适的生活。
You need to thank her for taking over from you the job of taking care of your son.
所以你应该谢谢她，因为她承继了你的工作来爱你的孩子。
The fact is that in any in-law conflict, nobody wins. And oftentimes it ends in misery and disaster.
所以呢，事实上呢，在所有姻亲的这些的矛盾当中呢，就是没有一个人能够赢的，而且呢，如果说要去较真的话呢，那一定是以悲剧来收场，或者是灾难来收场。
It is best to respect and appreciate each other's goodness and contribution.
所以的最好的方法就是要彼此尊重，而且彼此感激对方他们所贡献出来，还有他们所做的好的部分。
The proverb mother is not afraid of the addition of a daughter-in-law.She welcomes it, and she makes room for it.
一个像真言智慧的母亲呢，她不会害怕那个媳妇啊，她不会害怕多一个媳妇，她会欢迎她，而且会腾出空间来接受她。
Therefore, a blessed woman is one who sees values in others and in herself.
所以，一个蒙福的妇人呢，她是一个，她可以看见别人的价值，也可以看见她自己的价值。
She doesn't need to compete with anyone as she is secure in her own value as determined by God.
所以呢，她不需要跟任何一个人来比较，而且因为呢，她呢，在她自己的价值里面，神所给她的价值里面，她感受到她的安全感。
At my son's wedding, I gave over the job of taking care of my son to my daughter-in-law.
在我儿子的婚礼当中，我把我自己照顾儿子的这个责任呢，交给我的媳妇。
The burden is so much lighter.
所以我就感觉我好轻松哦。
And ever since then, I never stopped appreciating and marveling at what a great job she is doing.
所以从那之后呢，我都没有停止的来感谢，来惊叹我的媳妇她做的多么美好的工作。
My son's well-being, his success, his happiness all comes from his wife.
所以我儿子他所有一切的好处，他的成功，还有他的快乐，都是要从他的妻子，我的媳妇而来。
She is beautiful and she does a beautiful job.
我的媳妇她是个美丽的，而且她做的极美好的工作。
Yes, but a blessed home must not only have a blessed mother, it must also have a noble wife.
那我们看第二部分，就是一个蒙福的家庭。一个蒙福的家庭呢，不只是有一个，就说不单只有一定要有一个蒙福的母亲，而且要有一个很尊贵的妻子。
Proverbs 31 verses 10 to 31 are the instruction God gave for a virtuous wife.
箴言31章10到31节特别讲到神给一个有美德的妻子。 如何成为一个美德的妻子。
A lot of times, women do not understand that a happy home does not only depend on a good relationship with our children, but even more on a good relationship with our husband.
那许多的妇女呢，不太明白说一个快乐的家庭不单只是你跟你的儿女能够有美好的关系，甚至你应该跟你的配偶有美好的关系。
We devote our energy to our children very naturally because they need us and because they are much easier to love.
那我们跟我们呢花了很多的精力在我们的儿女身上，因为他们需要我们，而且他们也比较容易的来被关爱。
But only when they are young.
那只是在他们年幼的时候。
年纪大了就不再听，就不太听话了。
年纪大。
But those who devote their attention just to their children will find that in the long run, they will end up losing both their children and their husband.
那如果那些呢，只是把他们全心的注意在他们的儿女身上的，有很多时候你会发现呢，在长期下来，他们可能呢会失去他们的丈夫，也会失去他们的儿女。
How do we develop a strong relationship with our husband?
那我们要怎么样来建立一个这个强壮的、这个强有力的关系跟我们自己的配偶呢？
Let us read 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 3 to 5.
那我们来读彼得前书第三章三到五节。
你们不要以外面的编法戴金饰穿美衣为装饰，只要以里面存着长久温柔安静的心为装饰，这在神面前是极宝贵的。因为古时仰赖神的圣洁妇人正是以此为装饰顺服自己的丈夫。 So let's focus on the virtueOf a noble wife.
So, 我们来看这边讲到一个圣洁的妻子，她的美德。
She is profitable to her husband.
她对她的丈夫是有益的。
She seeks for his welfare so that her husband trusts her.
就像这个箴言说，她丈夫心里依靠她，必不缺少利益。
She is a true helper who will not let her husband down or put him to shame.
她是一个真正的一个帮助者，她不会使她的丈夫就是羞愧。
她丈夫心里依靠她，并不缺乏利益。她一生使丈夫有益无损。她丈夫在城门口与本地的长老同坐，为众人所认识。Sisters, we must ask ourselves this question. Do I make my husband look good or look bad?
所以姐妹们，我们要问我们自己，我们是不是让我们的丈夫看起来是好或是坏？
Do people look up to him because of you or do they look down on him because of you?
会不会人因着你呢，看不起你的丈夫或者是尊敬你的丈夫？
It's a cold and hostile world out there, and your husband needs all the help he can get from you.
就是你的丈夫很多时候他需要你的帮助，但是如果你常常用一些冰冷或者是一些很凶恶的态度来对他的
话，这个世界是很冰冷残酷
的，
所以你的先生绝对需要
你的
帮助。Yeah.Never compete with your husband before anyone or even before your children.
所以你永远不要在任何人面前把你的丈夫跟别人比较。
不要跟你的丈夫比较。
Never compete with your husband.
不要跟你的
丈
夫
比较。
Yeah, 不要想要胜过你的先生，不管是在外人面前或是在你孩子面前。Never put him down in public or in private.
不要在不私底下或是在公开的场合呢来好像践踏他。
Those who would not honor their husband cannot expect to be honored themselves.
那些呢不能够尊荣她的丈夫的话呢，那当然你也不会被尊荣。
So we need to have wisdom here and more communication.
所以我们需要智慧，也需要更多的来交通。
Because sometimes you may offend your husband without knowing it. You need to listen to your husband.
所以有些时候可能你无意之间呢，你得罪你的丈夫，你必须要来听一下他的心声。
Another thing is that the noble wife is diligent and industrious.
那另外一点呢，就是说一个有尊贵的妇女，她是很殷勤的，而且呢，她也是很乐意来工作的。
Let us look at the following verses in verse 15 and 18. Okay.
14-2.
Yeah.他寻找羊绒和麻，甘心用手做工。未到黎明，他就起来，把食物分给家中的人，将当做的工分派卑女。他觉得所经营的有利，他的灯终夜不灭。他观察家务，并不吃闲饭。So we see that the noble woman, she is willing to work with her hands. She rises early and goes to bed late, working to serve her family.
所以我们看到这边所有经文讲到这个一个才德的妇女呢，她很乐意用手来做工，然后她把食物分给家中的人，她观察家务，不吃闲饭。
She works hard for the needs of her family, and she doesn't do it.To show off or for her own sense of self-worth. She always put her family first.
她就是非常认真，非常殷勤的做工。她也不是只为她自己，她观察家务，看见家中的需要。
不是为她自己的荣誉感。
自己的荣誉。
Do you remember Rebecca in the Bible?
你记不记得利百加在旧约里面的？
She was the wife of Isaac, and Abraham sent his servant Eliezer to seek her out.
那这个她是那个以撒的妻子，那是亚伯拉罕送差他的仆人去帮以撒找的妻子。
And remember, Eliezer did not know where to find a wife for his master's son, so he prayed. He said, "Lord, help me find a girl."If she is the girl, make her promise that she will water, not only give me water, but water all my camels.
所以呢，他的仆人呢，他到了那地的时候，他就祷告，他说：“神啊，我要怎么样去为我的主人的儿子找妻子呢？祈求你给我，他遇到一个女子，他说让一个女子，她愿意给我水喝，也愿意给我的骆驼水喝。”
Do you know how many gallons of water a thirsty camel drinks?
那你知道吗？一只很口渴的骆驼，它能够喝掉多少的水吗？
25 gallons of water.
25加仑的水。
And do you know how many camels he had?
那你知道有多少只骆驼他带着？
10 camels.
10只骆驼。
So how much water does Rebecca have to draw?
所以你想想看，利百加她必须要去打多少的水呢？250加仑的水。
It's not an easy prayer to answer.
所以这个祷告实在是不容易来回应。
Rebecca must be kind, generous, hospitable, diligent, and strong.
所以利百加呢，她必须要是很有恩慈的，并且他是很友善的，并且他又能够很强壮的，很愿意去做的。
Proverbs 31:17，
在箴言书31:17，
他以能力束腰，使膀臂
有
力。So you also have to be strong and diligent.
你必须要很强壮，而且很殷勤。
She is also need to be generous.And compassionate.
他要很大方，要很慷慨，而且有同情心。
Proverbs 31:20. Let's read.
我们念箴言31:20。
他张手周济困苦人，伸手帮补穷乏人。She is not selfish but she cares for the needy. Her husband will respect her for her kindness, and her children will follow her example.
所以她一点都不自私，而且她会照顾到有需要的人。她的丈夫也非常的尊敬她的，有她的这个恩慈。她的儿女也从她学到榜样，要对别人，是要有恩慈的。
In addition, she needs to have foresight and not just work for the immediate.
所以她必须要有一个远见和计划。
Let's read chapter 31, verses 21 to 22.
那我们读21节到25节。
她不因下雪为家里的人担忧，因为全家都穿着朱红色衣服。她为自己制作绣花毯子，她的衣服是细麻和紫色布做的，能力和威仪是她的衣服。她想到日后的情况就喜笑。Over here, the Chinese translate to 朱红色 scarlet. But actually, the language, actually the original language, it means doubled, 就是说双层的。
这边他翻译中文翻成说他穿朱红色的衣服，事实上原文意思是双层的衣服。
That means they're very warm,
很温暖，
yes,
很暖和。
So,She works and plans for a good and honorable future.
所以你看她会规划，她来计划这些前面的这些的景况。
Mothers, do we know what kind of children we want to bring up?
做母亲的，你知不知道你所养的孩子，你是要把他养成什么样子？
We need to plan for the future by making wise decisions today.
所以我们必须要有远见，我们要知道怎么样来计划。
Do you control your child's use of technology?
你有没有稍微的管制一下你儿女他们在用这些现今的这些科技？
Or do you allow TV, iPad, phone as a babysitter?
或是你允许这些电视啊 iPad 或者是电话成为你的这个保姆在看顾他们？
What are the kind of friend, teacherthat you allow around your children? Are they giving your child the right kind of influence?
那你有没有注意到你儿女他们的朋友或是他们的老师，这些人是不是会给你的儿女一个有智慧的这个指导或者是不好的影响？
What is the most important characteristic that you want to instill in your children?
所以你希望你的儿女他能够有什么样最重要的品德是你所希望的。
Do not wait until they are all grown up and then you nag them.
你不要等到好像很多事情都坏了你才一直的唠叨他们。
Prepare them for it now.
你要现在你就要来预备。
And a noble woman, she would communicate in wisdom and in kindness. In verse 26, we see
一个有智慧的母亲，她会像箴言26节说的，她会用智慧和善意来沟通，就发智慧。
她舌上有仁慈的法则。A wise mother, she would use her tongue wisely to build up and not to tear down, to encourage and not to discourage. It doesn't mean that we will never agree, that we never disagree with our husband or children.
所以呢，一个有智慧的母亲呢，她会用她的口舌来建造她的儿女，而不是来摧毁她的儿女，也不是说呢，你就整天瞎赞美他，而不来指正他的错误。但是我们需要来学习有智慧。
We need to learn from Paul.
我们必须要从保罗。
The Apostle Paul.
保罗，使徒保罗。
He wrote a lot of letters to instruct the churches and sometimes warn them against unchristian behavior.
保罗书信呢？保罗他写了很多信给教会。他来指正来教导这些的很多不好的不是基督徒非世俗的这些的影响。
But he always makes sure that they understand that he is speaking out of love and concern.
那他永远他都会特别的会让教会知道他写这些指证的书信动机是为了爱跟关怀。
A husband may seem quite tough and stubborn to us, but they have a very fragile ego, especially before the woman he loves.
当然我们的丈夫呢可能他们会看起来是很固执而且他们但是呢事实上他们是有那个很脆弱的那种自我的欲望特别是在他所爱的妻子的面前。
So we need to use a lot of tender loving care.
所以我们需要用到很多很温和的爱。
Sometimes they need it more than our children.
有些时候有些丈夫呢他们需要的爱胜过儿女需要我们的爱。
So if you want your husband and your children to be attracted to you, then you have to make sure that your mouth is a pot of honey and not a pot of vinegar.
所以如果你想要用你要来吸引你的丈夫或是你的儿女的话那我们必须要留心我们的口要成为一个蜂蜜而不是成为一罐酸醋。
So these are the virtues of a virtuous wife. So sisters, if we set these as our guidelines, our husband and our children will rise up and call us blessed.
所以这些是那个才德妇女她的美德。所以姐妹们，我们必须要为我们自己设定一个目标来效法。那这样的话，我们的丈夫，我们的儿女，他们会起来。要称我们为才德的来祝福我们
Like in verse 29
在29节一样
才德的女子很
多唯独
你
超过
一切 We are not in competition with anyone just with ourselves
我们不要跟任何人来比较就是跟我们自己的旧的自己来比较
If we mess up yesterdayWith God's help, we can do better today.
如果我们过去已经搞得很糟了，那神会帮助我们从今天开始呢，能够越来越好。
As long as we try, we can count on the generosity of our family to praise us and to encourage us.
所以只要我们愿意来尝试，我们就可以知道呢，我们的家庭，他们会非常乐意的来赞美鼓励我们。
So God teaches us that all blessing comes from Him, and to have a blessed home, it has to start with one person, you.
所以神的话教导我们说呢，所有的祝福都是从神来的。那你要有一个祝福的家庭，最先呢，我们必须从一个有祝福的个人开始。
So God has chosen us.Dear sisters, as the channel of His blessing in our homes.
所以神选他选择了这个姐妹，选择了母亲或是妻子，成为一个祝福的管道来祝福我们的家。
To be a godly mother,
要成为一个敬畏神的母亲。
Dedicate your children to God.
把你的儿女来交托给神。
See nobility in your children.
看见你儿女的尊贵
Teach your children the ways of God
教导你的儿女当行神的道路
See value in yourself and in others
你要自己看重你自己和他人价值
Be a godly wife
要成为一个敬畏神的妻子
Be profitable to your husband
让你的丈夫是有益无损
Be diligent and industrious.
要勤奋，要辛勤做工。
Be generous and compassionate.
要慷慨，有同情心。
Have foresight and plan for the future.
对未来要有眼见和计划。
Communicate in wisdom and in kindness.
用智慧来善意的来沟通。
Some people may read chapter 31 of Proverbs and say,Why is all the burden on the women?
那有些人读了这个箴言三十一章会讲说干什么把所有的负担重担都给妇女呢
Where's the husband in all of this?
那丈夫男人跑哪儿去呢
Is his job just to sit at the gate and shoot the breeze?
那男人是不是他的工作只是坐在城门口跟人家聊天？
Well, let me remind you that God's word are meant for those who would listen.
所以呢，我要提醒大家，就是说，神的话是给那些乐意听的人。
If we desire God's blessings, we need to start with ourselves and not wait for others.
所以如果我们渴望得着神的祝福，我们必须从我们自己开始，而不是要等其他的人。
Those who would obey God's word will become the influencers and the changers in this world.
那那些愿意顺服神的话，并且能够成为一个，他可以成为一个改变世界的人。
Just like what I said of Paul, the apostle.
就像这个使徒保罗说的。
These have turned the world upside down.
他说到这些人是来使这个世界，是来翻转这个世界的，颠倒这世界的。
The world is on a wrong course.
这世界现今是在一个错误的方向里。
It's headed toward destruction.
它正向着这个毁坏前进。
And as God's people, we are called to interject with God's blessing and God's love into this world and God's life.
所以我们是神的儿女呢，我们是被呼召来要来把所有一切神所教导我们的哦，能够注入到家庭跟这个世界。
Starting with our homes.
从我们的家开始。
And actually, do you know that all these things that we discuss, they're not gender specific?
那你会发现我们今天所讨论的这些呢，并不是说是什么性别的区分。
You don't need to be a woman to set your children apart for God.
你不需要是妇女才把你自己的儿女来把他交托给神。
You don't need to be a woman to teach your children the way of God.
你不是只是妇女来教导你的儿女神的道路。
You don't need to be a wife to bring value to the people next to you.
你不是只是靠妻子来把神的价值观来教导你父亲的人。
来与人有益。
来与人有益处。
Yeah. And you don't need to be a woman to be generous and kind and diligent.
你不需要说 只是女人她必须要殷勤，她必须要慷慨或是有恩慈。
May we all obey the teaching of God and bless our homes.
但愿我们每一个都能够顺服神的教导，而且能够祝福我们的家庭。
Finally, let us bless ourselves, especially all the mothers, with the lastconcluding verses of this chapter, verses 30 to 31. This is also our memory verse.
所以我们要用这个箴言31章30-31节来祝福我们的母亲们。
所有的母亲。
所有的母亲。
我们可以一起来读。
我们一起来读。
艳丽是虚假的，美容是虚浮的，唯敬畏耶和华的妇女必得称赞。愿他享受操作所得的，愿他的工作在城门口荣耀他。Amen.
Amen.
Let us, 我们来最后唱一首歌。Let us sing the song. 爱我愿意。May we all say yes to love. And in God's love, be willing to submit to one another.Because we're going to need God's help.
Let's all stand. Can we stand?
Yeah, okay. 十字架上的光芒，温柔又慈祥，带着主爱的力量，向着我照亮。我的心不再隐藏，完全地摆上， 愿主爱来浇灌我在爱中的自由释放，我愿意降服，我愿意降服，在你爱的怀抱中，我愿意降服。亲爱的阿爸天父，我们真的是仰望你，我们来求你的帮助。 May you help us, O Lord. We ask for your help.
祈求你的帮助。
We know that we cannot do it without you.
我们知道我们离了你什么都不能做。
How can we be a woman of virtue?
我们要怎么样成为一个才德的妇人呢？
How can we be a good mother and a good wife?
我们要怎么样成为一个好的母亲、好的妻子呢？
Lord, unless I come to know you first.
主啊，是的，我只有能够首先来认识你。
When I first enjoy your love,
当我先来享受你的爱，
your acceptance,
你的接纳，
then may I be able to love and accept others.
那我才能够来爱跟接纳别人。
How can I be unselfish?
我要怎么样不自私呢？
Unless I know you.
除非我认识你。
And follow your example.
跟随你的榜样。
To put others first.
把别人放在前面。
Right now I need you, Lord.
主啊，我需要你。
I ask for your help.
我祈求你的帮助。
May you help each one of us here.
祈求你帮助我们在座每一位。
Mothers or fathers.
不论是母亲或是父亲，丈夫或是妻子，
We ask you for your help.
我们祈求你的帮助。
May I be right with you.
让我能够在你眼中是正直的，是对的。
May I connect with you.
让我能够与你紧紧的连接。
So that I may bring your blessing to others.
使我能够把你的祝福带给别人。
Hear my prayer.
听我的祷告。
In Jesus' holy name I pray.
奉耶稣基督的名，阿们，
阿们。哈利路亚，谢谢弟兄姐妹。若是有人在我们当中， If you do not know the Lord yet, and today you like a chance,
你要
to connect with him.
你今天想要跟神连结。
I invite you.
我邀请你
to stay after.
你可以留下来，等于待会儿
talk with me.
跟我来
I would love to share with you.
我乐意来跟你分享耶稣基督的福音。
So, may God bless you. Please be seated.
愿神祝福你，请坐。
大家主日平安。非常。感谢林师母跟我们这么美好讲到，我们今天是母亲节，我们先看一个短片，在我报告之前。我们先播一下短片啊。
25, walking up the aisle. You made the promise of your love. Blinked twice and you were 29, singing lullabies. And I looked up at you for the first time. Words fall short, and I am sure they'll never.You're strong like your father, even when you were scared. When I was in trouble, you never left me there. And you love like your mother, like there's nothing to lose. You're an unsung hero, so I'll sing this song for you. Woke upI was 21 and I fell in love. Remember how I told you that I'd search the world and I found the girl. And oh, how she reminds me of you. You're strong like your father, even when you were scaredTrouble, you never left me there. And you love like your mother, like there's nothing to lose. You're an unsung hero, so I'll sing this song for you. Times I fell down, you showed me how to stand. And when we crossed the ocean, you were my safe place to land. Been on a thousand stages, but when it's all said and done, I hope I'll make you prouder of the man that I've become. To be strong like my father, even when I'm scaredWhen someone's in trouble, I'll never leave them there. And I love like my mother, like there's nothing to lose. You're my unsung hero, and I sing this song for you.